Greetings, everyone. BJ Wiley here for our continuing testing of the Guild Wars Anniversary Region event here. So here we are in Umbral Grotto, and we've already done Fronis Iron Toes Lair, which we did in the second part of our previous video, which we also did Gollum to complete the Tarnished Coast region. So what we're going to do now is talk to Chorus Deeprunner here, who will allow us to get into the Secret Lair of the Snowmen. So after Fronis, Secret Lair is probably the second most quickest, easiest dungeon to get through, so we're going to test that next for qualification for the Depths of Tyria region. Now, it's kind of disappointing that Fronis doesn't actually qualify for that, because when you think about it, I mean, there are some other missions that do qualify for their respective regions. They're a lot quicker and easier to get through than, say, Fronis Iron Toes Lair. So for Fronis not to qualify is a bit disappointing. So we'll see if Secret Lair qualifies. If not, well, then it's going to obviously be one of the 16 remaining normal, quote-unquote, dungeons. But anyway, if this is the first time you're doing this, you won't be able to access this dungeon without having four pieces of a map that drop as random drops throughout the world. I believe it's only in the Northern Shiver Peaks that they do drop, or the Far Shiver Peaks, I should say. So you'll need one of each corner of the map in order to talk to him and actually activate this quest for the first time afterwards. You do not need the map. So we'll see how this goes.
Excuse me?
Looted yet. All right, now we have a serial with us. Where'd you go, dude? Hey, dude. Yo, dude. Oh, there you are, dude. Might as well pick up our thing. You might say. I probably should just call up my map here, too. Save some time, that way I know where I'm going. Although this is the same dungeon that is active during the Winter's Day events. Two arms! Two arms!
Through here.
of Syria, and the minions do all the work here since she's got the fire. Fire seems to work very well against these guys, eh? I'm still hunting. Racking up enemies like there's no tomorrow. Hmm. Now this is the fun bit. Up a bit and let the minions do some work. Seems to have done it. Thank you. get your boss key. Bleached? Well, that was easy. And as we did for Fronus, we will wait for this to take us back naturally, just to make sure there are no issues. So we'll pause here and then return in a couple of minutes. Okay, let's take a look. Nothing there. And no proof of legend, so we can confirm that Secret Lair of the Snowmen also does not qualify for anything. Even though, technically, it is a master's dungeon, right?
Greetings, hero.
Make sure that doesn't do it either. Nope. Okay, so we've confirmed that Secret Lair of the Snowmen also does not update this dungeon. Okay, so what's next? I think Ooze Pit is the next quickest one, so we'll see if that works or not. Here, as you can see, Doomlore Shrine in the Char Homelands. Where am I going? I'm going this way. So first, we need to talk to Seer Fierce Rain. Fierce Heart, no. Seer Fierce Rain.
The Char shall rule.
Thank you. for Siri to pick that up, since if she didn't pick up the snowman quest. There we go. And now, of course, we will map to Long Eye's Ledge and head on down here where the dungeon entrance is to the Ooze Pit. Okay, here we are, outside the Ooze Pit, so, without further... Ooh, pardon me, adieu. Shall we go in?
And see how this goes.
Ooh, pardon me. They will die. Or we will. I'm sure. What do I gotta do for this thing? Prismatic gelatinous material from the Ooze Pit. Okay, well, thanks. That helps a lot. Lagging. Okay. We have our unstable gelatinous material. Now what do we do with it? All right, it's just basically a balm. Ah, good. I'm glad I told myself. Area map. Thank you. Oh, lovely. Boulders. There's nothing rolling towards us. Thank you. so far, it looks like this alternative path to the wiki map is working out nicely. Out the path to the door. Now we just need to get the key. That nonsense out of the way. Well, at least he killed the oozes too. Crazy here. Here we go. Alright, so we're going to do this the smart way. Yeah. Alright, that worked out nicely. Something unstable, do we? Let me pause here while I go run for that. Alright, that didn't take too long. Oh boy, another fun part, eh? Alright, this is pretty much how it's going to go for here, so we'll take a pause to save some time until we get to this boss fight and get the key. Alright, that's that. Let's go get our key. Now the key, so we'll pause again while we run back to the boss door. Okay, here we go, the boss lock. Prismatic oozes. Alright, we'll see how this goes. Not as well as I hoped. I believe we got rid of most of the prismatic oozes. Two or three of them, I think, we killed off. So let's see what we got up here. Yes, we only have one prismatic left, eh? controls are going on me, thank you. Let's see if we can make this last gasp effort at this guy here. Again, we'll take a pause here and see what happens. Okay, we're back, and as you can see, once again, nothing. Nothing whatsoever. So quite disappointing that Depths of Tyria does not encompass all of the Depths of Tyria here.
You want something meat?
Again, still nothing, right? Yep, still nothing. How disappointing. So obviously, the Depths of Tyria only encompasses multi-level dungeons to start off with, and perhaps only certain ones at that. So, we'll have to see. That'll be the next video, but at least we're getting confirmation here for the future. Information's always good to have, so thanks for watching. And until next time, I'll see you in game.